Russia's recent use of a hypersonic missile against Ukraine's armed forces may sound scary, but the technology employed isn't particularly advanced. However, the next-generation hypersonic missiles under development by Russia, China, and the US pose a significant threat to global and national security. These missiles' maneuverability along their trajectories presents a challenge, requiring constant tracking due to their changing flight paths. An additional challenge arises because these hypersonic weapons operate within a distinct atmospheric region, flying higher than subsonic missiles yet lower than intercontinental ballistic missiles, ICBMs. Tracking this intermediate region is a difficulty faced by all parties involved. Russia asserts that some of its hypersonic weapons can carry nuclear warheads, which raises concerns even if not confirmed. If a country, like the US, were to perceive an incoming hypersonic missile as nuclear-armed, the likelihood of interpreting it as a first-strike attack increases. The rapid speed of these missiles diminishes the time available for diplomatic resolution, intensifying the risk. The most significant danger posed by modern hypersonic missiles is their destabilizing influence. Many military experts suggest that the US and its allies should promptly develop their own hypersonic weapons to incentivize nations like Russia and China to engage in diplomatic discussions about managing these systems. So, what exactly is hypersonic? It describes vehicles flying considerably faster than the speed of sound, which is around 761 miles per hour, 1,225 kilometers per hour, at sea level. While passenger jets travel at nearly 600 miles per hour, 966 kilometers per hour, hypersonic systems reach speeds of 3,500 miles per hour, 5,633 kilometers per hour, or even higher. Hypersonic technology has been around for decades. Yuri Gagarin's space capsule re-entered Earth's atmosphere at a hypersonic speed of around 17,000 miles per hour or 27,400 kilometers per hour during his historic flight in 1961. Intercontinental ballistic missiles, ICBMs, in global nuclear arsenals are also hypersonic, reaching speeds of about 15,000 miles per hour, 24,140 kilometers per hour, or roughly 4 miles, 6.4 kilometers, per second at their maximum velocity. ICBMs follow predictable trajectories, launching on large rockets that take them into space and back into the atmosphere. The new generation of hypersonic missiles travels at high speeds but not as fast as ICBMs. They are launched using smaller rockets, remaining within the upper atmosphere during their flight. There are three distinct categories of non-ICBM hypersonic weaponry: aeroballistic systems, glide vehicles, and cruise missiles. Aeroballistic systems are dropped from aircraft, accelerated using rockets to hypersonic speeds, and follow unpowered trajectories. Russia's Kinzhal missile, used against Ukraine, falls into this category, with its origins dating back to around 1980. Hypersonic glide vehicles, on the other hand, are boosted by rockets to high altitudes and then maneuver along a gliding trajectory to reach their targets. Examples include China's Dongfeng 17, Russia's Avangard, and the US Navy's conventional prompt strike system. Concerns have been raised about China's advanced glide vehicle technology compared to the US. Hypersonic cruise missiles, the third type, achieve hypersonic speed through rocket boosters and sustain it using air-breathing engines called scramjets. These missiles require smaller launch rockets, making them cost-effective and deployable from various locations. Both China and the US are developing hypersonic cruise missiles, with the US testing a scramjet missile in March 2020. The key motivation behind developing next-gen hypersonic weapons is their formidable defense evasion capabilities, attributed to their speed, maneuverability, and flight paths. The U.S. is working on a multi-layered defense strategy involving space-based sensors and collaboration with allies. This approach, though effective, comes with substantial costs and a lengthy implementation period. Considering the current focus on hypersonic weaponry and defense strategies, evaluating their threat to national security is crucial. Hypersonic missiles with conventional warheads can effectively target high-value assets, like aircraft carriers, impacting major conflicts. However, their high cost hinders large-scale production. As observed in Russia's recent use, hypersonic weapons are not necessarily a silver bullet that ends a conflict.